Thai friend Wannee again.
Sawadee ka.
Sawadee ka. Not only is she a Thai teacher, but she's a professional masseuse. So we thought we would just talk today about the rotator cuff, because a lot of musical injuries happen because we stress the rotator cuff. And correct me if I'm wrong. The humerus sits inside the, but it's not a full socket. It's got, it can move on three sides. So the way we stabilize this joint is with the rotator cuff.
And I can show you
and
the way.
And it's four muscles. The four muscles.
Okay. This one, okay. On top is supraspinatus, and just about an inch lower, this one is infraspinatus. And teres major and teres minor is on the side. If you have someone with you, ask them to press that, you will feel so good. And one that she want to talk about today is the subscapularis. The sub means under, so it's under your scapula. Under that, go lateral, I mean.
Yeah, so the inside.
It's like right there, you can grab it.
The subscapularis is from the inside of your shoulder blade coming forward to the chest. That's why the subscapularis and your pecs together, when they're contracted, will both make you with the bad posture and the forward head tilt. So part of getting better posture is to stretch out the subscapularis and the pecs.
Mm-hmm.
Subscapularis stretch. So if you take your elbows against the wall and then you bend at the wrist and you put your fingertips together and then you come down, bend your knees, you'll feel intense stretch in the back of your armpit.
So tight because you've been doing this.
So
it's shortened.
So mine is very short. So Wannee just taught me this.
This is another one, the good stretching for subscapularis.
So if you take the
pole,
and you bend your arm up, and you've got your hand on the bottom, and then you.
She's very stiff.
I'm so stiff. She's like, she really thought I would be a lot more flexible, but I can't go very far.
Arm.
In both cases, I can't really do it because.
I'm gonna show you. I'm a sound therapist, but I'm not playing.
Yeah, how should we do
like you,
it?
So. See, so easy when I do it because I'm not that stiff.
So another way to stretch your subscap is in the sleeper pose. So you're on your side, head on a block or a pillow, and you put a roller under the armpit. And in fact, you could just roll over like that. If you're like me, you've got very, very tender spots called trigger points, and you could just hold your weight over the maximum point of tension. And while you're doing that, you're creating a state of anoxia if you hold it for 10 to 30 seconds, and then you gradually stretch it in that state where you're depriving it of blood supply. And then you are able to bring in the blood flow by doing that. Notice that it's not a smooth roll because there's a very firm cord in my subscap that's not. It's going chunk, 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 like a big guitar chord in there because it's a trigger point right now. It's very tense. So one last stretch of your subscapularis is to line your foam roller, reach out and grab your chihuahua. Perfect. So you get that little weight, 10-pound weight against your axilla, and that helps to get the inside of the shoulderly muscles, the subscapularis stretched. Oh, it's very hard. Let's do the other side, Mr. B. Come here. I think he realized he's being used, so he's. Come here. Oh, going away in disgust. Good boy. And then you got a little bit of resistance again, your subscap. There you go. Oh, yeah. Oof. Yeah, Mr. B.
All right, we all are learning.
Hope that was helpful.
Thank you.
Oh,
Khap khun ka.
Khap khun ka.